Dr. Stehling, you have developed a novel method for treating prostate cancer. Can you explain how it works and what the advantages are?
Sure. Over the last 7 years, we've used a method called Irreversible Electroporation, or IRE, for the treatment of prostate cancer. So far, we have successfully treated approximately 650 patients with this method. The main advantage of IRE over conventional treatments, such as radical prostatectomy and radiation therapy, is the very low rate of side effects. In those 650 men we've treated, we have never induced any incontinence with IRE, and less than 10% of the men that we've treated have developed impotence. This compares very favorably with the results after prostatectomy, which has an incontinence rate somewhere between 20 and 50% and an impotence rate of the order of 70%, clearly much higher than IRE. This breakthrough was made possible by the unique mechanism by which IRE destroys cancer. IRE selectively destroys cells, but preserves the tissue infrastructure, such as fibers, vessels, and nerves. This is particularly important in the case of prostate cancer, because the prostate is surrounded by many very delicate anatomical structures. For example, the neurovascular bundle and the urinary sphincter, the structures which are responsible for the erection of the penis and bladder control. These structures are almost invariably destroyed by surgery and radiation, but also by other methods such as HIFU, high energy focused ultrasound. Well, I should say that we were quite lucky that we had the opportunity here to work with the inventor of irreversible electroporation, Professor Boris Rubinsky from the University of California in Berkeley, for many years now. It was this collaboration really that enabled us to develop an in-depth understanding of IRE, both from the scientific and from the clinical point of view. For example, one important discovery that we made during this collaboration was that IRE is much more complex than previously thought, but also much more versatile. We think that this research was crucial for us to achieve the high success rates we have with IRE for local tumor control, really comparable to the gold standard prostatectomy, and the very low rate of impotence of just under 10%, and zero incontinence. And not only that, we also were able to expand the range of treatments from early focal cancers to advanced T4 cancers, cancers that have infiltrated or grown into surrounding organs. In our clinic, IRE has in fact become a problem solver for patients with advanced cancers. For example, those with rectal infiltration, which cannot be treated by surgery or radiation therapy anymore. And of course, for patients with recurrent cancers after prostatectomy and radiation therapy.
That is quite amazing. Are there other advantages of IRE compared to surgery?
Yeah, many. For the patients, it's probably most important that besides preserving their erectile function and urinary continence, the whole treatment is minimally invasive, virtually pain-free, and can be completed within a few days without the need for a lengthy hospital stay and rehabilitation treatment afterwards.